There's an old definition of community. It dates back to the Stoics. A community is a group of people who have the same object of respect. The idea being that this is what keeps everyone in harmony. The same principle applies inside the mind. We've talked many times about how the mind is like a committee. And what we want to do is make that committee into a community. We have to have something that the whole mind respects. And there's a phrase in that chant of respect that we do often, Sikhaya Debagarawa, respect for the training. This is what allows the training to continue. Allows us to keep the precepts, to keep the mind focused on concentration, keep it centered, and to keep it looking into the issues of discernment, how to understand suffering and stress, how to put an end to them. That's the principle that we can use to bring the whole mind together and keep it together. It's easy enough to give your assent to these things, but it's maintaining that assent that makes all the difference. It's like when you're sitting and concentrating, you say, focus on the breath. Anybody can focus on the breath. The issue is staying focused on the breath. And to do that requires respect for the training. Because our mind normally tends to be pretty promiscuous and goes around looking into this, looking into that, shacking up with this, shacking up with that. No real respect, just going from one person to another. One thing to another. But if you have real respect and real loyalty, that changes the relationship. So try to maintain an attitude of respect towards this center that we're trying to develop here. Realize how important it is. Don't let the mind step on it to go someplace else. If we have respect for this, then it's a lot easier to withstand the pull of other objects for the mind, other things you could think about, other things you could look at, other things you could listen to. You stay right here. You maintain this center that we're working on. This way the mind, the training has a chance to develop. It goes someplace because you stick with it, through thick and through thin, when it's boring, when it's interesting, when it's hard, when it's easy. Try to stay right here in the midst of this changing world. You try to have an unchanging center. That's what it means to have respect. There's a sense of priority. Some things are more important than others. When you have that attitude, then it's possible for changes to come about. It's like that whole issue about, they talk about making everything sacred. Well, if everything is sacred, nothing is sacred. It all gets very undifferentiated. Anything, any place you land is equally sacred, so why bother staying in any one place? Just move around. When something is sacred, that means it is special. And you give it special care. That's the attitude of respect we're trying to develop here. The word, one of the words for respect is garu. In Pali, it means something that's heavy. In other words, this is where you place weight in your life. The practice has weight. Other things may be sort of flimsy and insubstantial, but the practice has weight for you. And then when it has weight for you, it gives ballast to the mind. So you don't get blown off by whatever comes your way. When you're dealing with other people, you still have this inner sense of gravity, center of gravity that stays solid. When you're by yourself and all kinds of thoughts can come blowing past, you stay centered. There's a weight to the mind, not a heaviness, but it's a solidity that keeps it from getting blown away. This is what it means to have respect. That this center of the mind, which seems like such a tiny little thing, and it is a tiny little thing, and it's so easy to drop it and go someplace else. But if you give it respect, it begins to take on a larger space. It totally depends on your respect for it to have that larger space. Otherwise, it gets crowded out. But what you want to do is take that sense of center and then let everything else in the body relate to that center. Spread, seem like it's spreading out from that center. Your awareness spreads out from that center. Your breath can spread out from that center. Everything gets organized. Everything has a common point. That takes this committee in the mind and takes all these disparate elements we have in the body and brings them together and makes them a community, something that can live together in peace. When there's that sense of community, then the mind can grow, the practice can develop, because everything, all the elements of the mind are working together. When you've got everybody working together, even a heavy job can become light. It's because this center here has weight, has solidity. And again, it's your attitude that gives it the solidity. The breath in itself is such a light thing. It's so easy to look past it towards other things, and that's what we've been doing for most of our lives. But now we understand it's important, so we try to give it more weight. Make it loom larger in our awareness, make it loom larger in our sense of priorities. And this gives the mind steadiness. We're looking for the deathless, and before we get the mind to the deathless, we first have to make it steady. It's like riding on a train and wanting to jump off the train. If you jump off the train while the train is going very fast, you could hurt yourself. But you wait for the train to slow down, and then you jump off. So you try to slow down the mind, make it more and more steady. Less likely to fly off after this, fly off after that. And the more steady the mind gets, then the easier it will be to take aim at that spot of non-fashioning, where things open up to the deathless. Otherwise, we jump past it here. The momentum of the running around mind just keeps us from aiming properly at that spot of no intention, no fashioning in the mind at all. Like that Dharma talk where John Lee says, if you want to make the mind zero, you first have to make it one. So you make it one, and then you try to keep it one. It's the keeping it one that makes it possible to turn it into zero. It's very unglamorous but important process of learning to maintain the good things you've got. They may not seem all that good, but it's in the maintaining them that makes them good. Just as they may not have much weight in and of themselves, but you give them weight, you give them solidity by your attitude of respect, your attitude of loyalty, your appreciation of their importance. When you go out in the world, you find that they'll be telling you all kinds of other things are important. You've got to resist that. You've got to maintain this center inside. Otherwise, you get pulled here, pulled there, and everything gets pulled to pieces. But if you maintain this one center, keep it going in the midst of all the other activities of the day, all the other activities of your life, it can amount to something. It develops the solidity of your attitude. It develops the timelessness of your effort. The consistency of your effort. And this way it really can make big changes in your life.